Looking for a free and easy way to record your screen? In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use the completely free version of Camtasia's online screen recorder. We'll cover everything from getting started to the best features, like collaborative editing. Hey everyone, and welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how to use a fantastic free tool for screen recording, the Camtasia free online screen recorder. That's right, it's completely free. There's no watermark on your videos, and you don't even need a credit card to get started. This is perfect for creating quick tutorials, presentations, or video messages. Let's dive in. First thing, head over to camtasia.techsmith.com. I'll put the link down in the description so you can just click on it. At this point, you do need to create an account for this. You won't have to install any software, but just go ahead, click sign in. You can see how quickly you can get signed up. Here we are, all logged in. You can see how easy the interface is to use. We can just start clicking on things. I want to point out, I do use Camtasia to make all my YouTube videos. I don't use this version. I have a paid for version that's an installed app on my computer. I'll put the link down below if you want to learn more about that. Now, let's go ahead and just start clicking on this first one, screen and camera, where we're going to record myself and the screen. All right. Let's pick screen and camera. Now, when we go and do this, it's asking, first of all, what do I want to share? Is it a Chrome tab? So I have Gemini open here. Maybe I was doing a tutorial on Gemini. I could select this and it will record that screen. I have all these different windows open. Here I have Microsoft Excel open here. So I could just make sure it focuses on that. Or I could do the entire screen. I have dual monitor. So this is my left monitor. This is my right. If I was going to do Chrome tab and I want to make sure that there is sound captured, make sure you have this turned on here. If I go back to window, I'm going to make this on Microsoft Excel. I'm going to click share. You'll see right away that it goes to this default. I've been using it before, so it might remember some of my previous settings, but it's super easy to change. So if I go look at the screen focus, as I click on different ones, you'll see that I go in different places. So if I go here, the Excel goes small. If I switch it, you can see how fast I can make these changes to any of these. So you can get kind of everything set up the way you would like. You can also go to customize. So if I go to customize here, we can change variations. So if I click on it, if I want to go on the different side, it will be variations of the one that I chose. We have different effects that we can add. You can see as I quickly click on different effects, if I click off of them again, it turns them off. So just remember, if you click it on, click it again to turn it off. And we have different backgrounds that we can choose from, and you can see how it goes. Everything's just a quick click. Now I want to point out, we can turn our microphone camera on and off here. We can select our different cameras. We can select our different microphones. I can turn the screen sharing on and off. I haven't started recording yet. The other thing I want to point out, this is where you're going to name your project up here. So if I just call this test, you can see this is 1080p. Let's go ahead and record a scene here. I'm going to go just click recording. You'll see that it's going to count down 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And I'm going to go over to Microsoft Excel here. And I'm just going to click on a few things. I'll type a few numbers on here. Down below, we can see stop sharing on it. But if I click stop sharing and then it goes back and I hop back over and we have it right here. So I'm going to hit play.
Microsoft Excel here. And I'm just going to
click. I'm using a different mic for that. So it's not picking up as well as this mic that I'm using. I have two different mics being used.
On a few things, I'll type a few numbers on here.
Now, some other things you can do with anything you record is, if I didn't want something at the beginning, I could go ahead and trim it. So I can trim it from both sides and I can just click done. So you can, if you have those things at the beginning or the end that you want to remove, a lot of times I always have some silent ones that are looking at the camera, then I can trim it back. Now, you can go ahead and add continuous scenes. So I could add another scene to this. And what do I want? Well, maybe I just want to talk for a while. I could just choose camera. And as soon as the camera goes on, there I am. You can see the background is still the same that I had before, which would make sense to keep it the same through. But you can go to customize. If you want to make any changes again, you can just quickly click on any of the different ones. And we have our different backgrounds here. So everything's super easy to use. We just hit start recording. Each segment is going to be maximum 5 minutes long. But I find with even the videos that I make, I rarely go over 5 minutes in a chunk. I just put them all together. Down below, you can quickly reorder any of these by dragging them, and you can even click delete to delete any of the scenes. If you're having troubles with maybe you're connecting your mic or you're having problems with your camera, do make sure that your permissions are correct. So if you go up to here, I'm going to click and notice that I have everything turned on. By default, these might be off. You just got to make sure that the permission is given for your microphone, camera, and sound. So make sure you check that if you're having any problems. The other thing I want to point out is the invite. This is another super easy thing. Do you want to collaborate with other people? So if I click invite, all I have to do is put an email in, and then they'll be able to collaborate with me on the different scenes. So you can easily put this together a lot faster and work together. Let's say you're all done. You can go ahead and export, and you can go to this export video, and it's going to be preparing the down file. This is pretty quick. I'm doing a quick run through so you can start playing with this right away. My download is complete. Here it is right here. If I click on it, I'll open it up
here, and I'm just going to click on a few things.
And this is already saved on my computer. I know this one's not very professional. Now, the last few things I want to point out with this is that if I go back and click the C here, it brings me back to my projects. I can see where this is right here. I could go through, make an edit. I can delete it, and I can go through and start a new project. Now that's the Camtasia free screen recorder. Super easy to use. I really like how you have the camera focused and you can just quickly click on different options or go to the screen focused and change it around and have their backgrounds. Everything is super quick to use. And that invite feature, that's great. I don't see a lot of them with that feature. So thanks for watching this week on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.